Good morning, and thank you for joining us here on Renew. Again, it is Monday morning, and looking forward to getting in the Word each and every day with all of you, and we hope that you'll be able to join us on Renew each day this week. Today's Renew is entitled, Remember Whose You Are. What a powerful thought. And today's scripture is found in John chapter 8 and verse number 12. And in this text, we see that Jesus is the light of the world. Listen to this scripture in John 8 and verse number 12. It says, Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Again, today's devotional, whose, remember whose you are. When Jesus said in this scripture, I am the light of the world, he was defining himself. He was saying, I know who I am. At least 18 times in the Bible, Jesus uses that word, I am, these words, I am. And then he gave a description. He described himself as the door. He described himself as the bread of life, or the way, or the truth, or the resurrection, and the life. Over and over, he defined himself. Jesus knew who he was and still is, and as a result, he was not under or had to deal with any pressure. Jesus understood his identity. Do you understand your identity? It's crucial that we understand whose we are. When you're unsure about your identity, many times we're pressured to fit into other people's molds. Maybe other people will try and make you what they think you should be rather than who God made us to be. You know, that oftentimes can lead to stress. Stress comes from trying to be somebody that you're not. When you fear you'll accidentally drop your facade and people will discover who you really are, then many times that can lead to stress. The way to counterbalance external pressure is to have an internal sense of satisfaction about who God made you and made me and made us to be. We will discover who we are by knowing whose we are. The Bible says we were created by God. We are deeply loved by Him. We are accepted as we are. He has a plan for our lives. When you and I understand this, we'll find ourselves free to serve and to serve other people. Jesus constantly did things that surprised everyone else. Why? Because he was free. He knew who he was. He felt no pressure to meet people's expectations. He chose to serve others regardless of how it might even be perceived. Think about it. He washed his disciples' feet, something they were too insecure to do for each other. Jesus always served from a position of strength. He knew who and whose he was. Let me ask you this question. Do you want to live in the same freedom Jesus did? Find security today in knowing that we are dearly loved and we are a dearly accepted child of Almighty God. There's no need to pretend to be anyone else. Let's pray, and then I want to ask you a couple questions today. Heavenly Father, thank you for this Monday. Lord, I pray that we will remember whose we are as a child of you, as a child of Almighty God. I pray that we will remember who we are. Our identity will be in you. And as a result of that, as Christians, Christ-like followers of you, God, that we will be able to free to be able to serve you, serve others because of whose we are. I pray today, all through today, that we will continue to cling and remember and have this security and this identity in you of whose that we are. In Jesus' name, amen. Think about this. I want you to do this. Some of you will, some of you won't. That's okay. But make two lists today. Make two lists. Make one list of what people say about you, or or maybe even sometimes what you might say of yourself. And then I want you to write a list of what God says about you. You are His beloved. You are accepted in Him. You are a child of His. And write a list of as many things that you can write down of what God says about you. And here's the question I have for you today. Which list will you choose to find your identity in? Remember whose you are. Pray that all of you have a good rest of your day. And remember Romans 12:2, that scripture, that theme scripture for Renew, about not being conformed to the world, but being renewed by the transforming of your mind. And prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Hope everyone has a wonderful day. And today on this Monday and this week, remember whose you are.